Good evening, Fleet Activities Yokosuka, Keigo Nagishi, Captain Dave Glenister. With me, as always, is Master Chief Marty King. And we're here to take your comments, give you some feedback on those. A lot of you got your feedback already. Hopefully you have, if you gave your contact information. There's a couple of folks out there that have not gotten that word for some inexplicable reason to do that. But we'll jump right in. So normally I kind of start out with a couple of informational statements. And I've chosen to weave that into the responses here because we've got a pretty good spread of responses. We do have a lot of BZs to individuals, and we do have some not so pleasant feedback from some folks that may have not been doing the right thing occasionally, and we've taken some action on those. So I've kind of glossed over some of that stuff. I actually pulled a couple out here. But I will start out here by saying I would like to thank you very much for posting someone outside Wamel Gate during the afternoon commute. Directing the flow of traffic to the left. This single act reduced my travel time by 30 minutes easily. So as you may remember, as you leave Wamel Gate, you are required to make a left-hand turn by the city of Yokosuka.
Yes, sir. Yep.
Not necessarily us. We are trying to help enforce that. And so we have put somebody out there, I guess, occasionally to kind of help you remember your obligation to follow Japanese law. And there are some folks that would prefer to all kind of go straight, but that has really slowed things up. So since you can make that left-hand turn, and there's no traffic light there, you can just keep rolling out of the gate as long as you just go and make that left and kind of get back to Route 16. That's really not too hard of a problem.
Yep.
So, yes. But there are a few traffic changes we are going to make as well. One of them I'm going to talk about we are strongly considering, and by that means we're probably going to do this, is bringing your bicycle back on base. And that is when you're coming through the main gate, like Kearney Gate, and you bring your bicycle back on. We are strongly considering, and you may interpret that as we're probably going to do this, to make you come in through the main ECP. And the reason we're doing that is because a lot of folks will bring their bicycle through that walkway, boardwalk there. They're on the wrong side of the road to start, and they just stay on that wrong side of the road for their duration here on the base. So we want to try and force traffic to do the appropriate things just easier. That way when you hop on your bike, once you're through the gate, you're already on the left-hand side of the road. Remember, bicycles flow with traffic. They are vehicles. They flow with traffic. So just so you know, do not be surprised. You shouldn't be surprised. And we'll start that up. We'll put the word out first and have a date for that. Okay, next one here. I recently went to the Navy College office near the end of the workday. Well, that's a mistake. Well, anywhere at the end of the workday. But at the end of the workday to get information on colleges and degrees. They are the right spot. The staff member gave me some information, but did not provide me with enough information on what colleges I could attend with the degree I am searching for. He told me to go look up the colleges online, choose one, and come back and find out if I could attend it, and we go from there. That does sound like something one of our counselors would probably tell you. But this is the level of customer service information the Navy College's office is putting out to sailors. What's the purpose of the office? Well, I'd say if you're waiting for everyone else to do your homework for you, why are you going to look at college? Okay, you got to do your homework. Now, there are thousands and thousands and thousands of colleges out there. You have to do your research to figure out and narrow down what works for you. If you were to walk in there and say, with the degree I'm looking for, what colleges are out there, you'd probably say, here's a list of 3,000. That's not enough to go on. Only you know the follow-on questions. What are you willing to do? What are you willing to work on? Are you looking for night school? Looking for degrees? Are you going to go locally? Are you going to do partial? Are you looking for associates? There's a lot of questions, and there's a whole lot to balance. I remember even at a high school, that is that's like a project. It's like a big homework or something. Trying to figure out what colleges you're even eligible for. And if you can get down to 10 after a couple of months, that's a big deal. So it is no small decision. There's just not enough information to go on at the end of the workday. Yes, of course you want to look it up online. And then the councils will work with you, but they're not going to spoon feed you, and nor should they. I mean,
it's personal. It's the school's for you. They do have some great folks over at the college office. Matter of fact, Mr. John Way will be leaving us shortly, who's been a mainstay.
Yeah.
But I do your research, and then go back and talk to them, and be more knowledgeable when you go in and get there, and then they could probably do better at answering your questions.
Yeah, I mean, and that's really what they're telling you to do here. But that's not inappropriate to say, go online and find all these colleges. Now, if you're going to look at some of the programs we have here on base, obviously, then you could go. But if you're looking at a very broad range of stuff, looking at forestry or something like that, land management, some things they don't offer here, but you want them somewhere else, which is totally valid, then of course, you got to do your own homework. Okay. All right, here's one that, actually, I mentioned it. So, I'm a very concerned parent, as am I. I'm a very concerned parent. My children attend classes and events held at the Community Readiness Center. That's the one right across from the Red Brick area. I am shocked with the overall appearance and the cleanliness of the entire building. Really, the entire building? That's unwarranted. Especially the bathrooms. The bathrooms have a buildup of stains on the floor and back areas, very unsanitary. Okay, the walls are drawn on and marked up. What's happening? When is the base CO? That would be me, I believe you're referring to. Going to do something about this. I guess I'll do it right now. He visits this building for ARB twice a week. Does he not notice the difference? Actually, I visit at least four times a week.
Yes, sir.
I go there AOB Monday, AOB Friday. I go there Monday nights for Cub Scouts and Tuesday nights for Boy Scouts. And some once a month, there's like 60 scouts, I mean, age 6 to 10. So you can imagine what happens there. And it is a constant challenge to keep care of. I'll tell you what happens with these things. And, of course, the answer, we answer your question. We clean the bathrooms once per day based on our CNIC guidance, which is it, you know, once a day. A lot of times these nighttime events, the cleaning may have already happened. And I will share with you a sense of frustration myself that some of these youth groups go in there, and these parents do not go in the bathrooms with their children, and the children trash them. And the youth groups do not go in after their event's over and clean them up. Now, we use the CODO room as like room 212. It's that big one in the middle of the second floor. A lot of you know that one. And so when we're done with that thing, I mean, we sweep it, we clean it, because we know we did something there. That should apply to the bathrooms as well. So I'm going to take this for action. And I think that we are going to make these organizations responsible for cleaning up the bathrooms too. Because I walked by there, and there was a couple of kids playing with a water fountain. Hawaiian Punch is all over the walls, and the parents just let them. So when you're not a parent, never. Okay, you cannot advocate your parenting just because you brought your kids in for one of these youth organization things and let them run through the place. Your kids go to the bathroom, you should go in there and make sure they did not trash it, because oftentimes they do.
Yep.
And I have taken upon myself to redirect the effort of some small children back to doing some cleaning while I've been there, but I'm not there all the time. But I'm probably there as much as anybody in the community, just because I'm there for, you know, at least four times a week, so 3 days a week I'm in there. So yeah, it's a good comment. It gets used a lot. It's getting used a lot. But you, when you're parents and you're there, you make sure your kids are doing the right thing and not drawing on the walls. It does happen, unfortunately. So, and then also there's a couple more comments from the same thing. I can't tell you why I know that. But I know that. Yes, I know you. In no event did you actually leave your contact information. You should have. And you basically said the same thing three times. So I got your message, but you have a responsibility to this too. One of these ones says the Community Readiness Center is so hot. If you went to the council on the fourth floor, it's extremely hot. This is obviously an older comment it's not an older comment, it's just a couple weeks ago. But I asked the councilor why it's so hot. They said that it's inconvenient because we haven't turned on the air conditioning units. Now, as you know, we do a cutover of several weeks when we could go from hot to cold. We save money by doing that. We're required to do that. And it says, we don't turn everything on until it's 76 to 78 degrees or something. But it's definitely in the 80s. There was a couple days where it was warm there. Well, I'll just say, one, you don't know hot. I mean, yes, it is warm, and I apologize that you're inconvenienced, but that is not hot. I mean, if you haven't been to Djibouti, and I just like saying the word Djibouti. Djibouti is about 138 degrees in August. And I am not joking. You can look it up and the World Almanac, 138 degrees in August. I was there, it was like 95 in the wintertime, and everyone was thrilled it was 95. So that's not good. No, we are not going to necessarily change our policy now. This is all just kind of passing over now. AC is going to come back on here. But I will give you some good news. So I don't mean completely sarcastic on this thing. Yeah, it gets hot in our buildings, and yeah, we have to live with it. Have to open our windows and doors. But the good news is, which we found out today, which is probably a week ago by the time we watched this thing, is that we will be allowed to open all of our pools. That is the Command Hill pool. I believe our plan is to use that for swim lessons. The Green Beach pool, we used to, which normally kind of looks like a Caddyshack moment because it's the only pool we have open in the summer. We're going to have that open as well for rec swim. And we're going to have the Purdy Gym open as well for training, swimming, you're going to work on your triathlon or whatever you want to do. So that's big news. That is, and it took a little interaction, took the support of the region, so we thank them very much, and you should thank them too. And so we're going to have three pools open.
Yes, sir. It's a great deal. Great deal.
Here's a next one, to whom it may concern. And it gives the date. They're in the bowling center, and there were a couple young young Marines who are using all kinds of profanity and offending people in the center. So, one, you should feel free to go up to anyone in life when they're using profanity and doing something out of sorts and say, hey, you know, please respect everyone else here. And hopefully they will. But also, I am pleased to report that I am bringing back the minor offense report, of which some of us have been here a long time remember, and little things like, kind of like a ticket warning type thing for all sorts of minor infractions, from wearing your pants too baggy, to wearing earrings when you shouldn't, to using profanity in public. And I'm going to catch you. Maybe not me personally, or maybe it is me personally. I may give myself a ticket book. But yeah, this is ridiculous. I've heard this before. We even have an ad running. Some of the ads are kind of cheesy that we have running. You probably may see some during the break here. But the point is totally valid, and it's meant to be valid. Profanity, I have never found profanity to be required. I will not say in a moment of youth and weakness that I didn't swear like a sailor, the sailor that I am, occasionally or something like that. I don't think there's very few people who can say they've never have. But I have never found profanity to be required. I think, you ever seen, let's see, what movie is it? Godfather?
Yes.
Violent movie, okay. But there is no profanity in it. Do you know that? In the whole movie. And it is all about gangsters and mobsters. I can tell Cosa Nostra, I'm Italian, right? The Five Families. But there's no profanity in it. And nothing is lost on that, in the terms of the deviousness of the story. If you haven't seen it, you should. Very few movies, actually, that and the sequel both got the Oscar for Best Picture. Godfather, Godfather 2, no profanity. So think about that, watch those. But yeah, we're gonna bring back the minor offense report and have some folks out there. That's gonna be valid to get that one. Okay, these people. I reapplied for a bedroom townhouse and stated that you wanted to live on base in Yokosuka. But they didn't offer you one in Yokosuka, there's only one in Ikego. We felt it was unfair because we told them that we didn't want Ikego. Well, that's totally fair. I can't give you what I don't got. You know? I can't. So, and this went, there's actually two from the same individual. His wife wrote in another one. It's the same deal. So the housing assignment is the housing assignment. If you are allowed to be reassigned housing, and there's only two circumstances that really come to mind for normal reasons. One is, your family has grown, which happens. Some folks live here for years and years, and now you're eligible for a larger unit, and that's great. And so congratulations on your expanding family. You may go there and apply for housing, even if you already have it. The other one is if you are commissioned, whether it be, LDO is a little rare because usually they try and move you around. LDO warrant, and then some of the other ones where you're going to go off the knife and fork and come back to command here in Yokosuka. Then you also can apply for new housing. And sometimes people stay where they are. You know, especially if, hey, I'm already in a four-bedroom, why would I apply for another four-bedroom? A lot of times it doesn't happen that way because it's a lot of our more senior enlisted folks.
Yes.
Good on them. Congratulations for those who fall in that category. But I can't give you what I've got. So you go there just as if you newly arrived. You show up on that day. They give you a list of what's available that day, and you've got 48 hours to make up your mind. And if you don't like what's on the list, you don't have to. If you already live in a house, you don't have to take it, but your housing assignment is complete. So we're not going to have you wait down in housing, wait for something to pop like the New York Stock Exchange, and everyone starts jumping on it. You got what you got. And it's the only way we can keep it fair. Otherwise, those folks who say are allowed to take 3 days leave and camp out there versus the folks who can only come one time and do that stuff, you got your list. You get to pick from it. And I thought this was I wouldn't say it was novel, but I thought this was, very obviously, we should do this. We should let people pick what they want. But that is not true. So we came here, or I came here, and people being assigned a house. And there's reasons why they were doing that. I totally get it. When you have houses on your inventory that have been out of the inventory a long time, it kind of shows in your metrics, which I'm not as interested in how long houses have been unoccupied, but it weights your numbers this way. You've got a unit that has not had someone in it for 270 days or something. But I don't really care what houses are filled versus empty as long as we're filling them. So Sure, go ahead and pick from anything available. Well, there are some, like, you know, I'll tell you, some of the other bases, I think even Zama. No, you got what you got. Or maybe it's Kalish, maybe it's Fatima. It's, I think it's one of the Marine ones. You got what you got. So, anyway, no, there's no process foul. And no, we don't owe you Yokosuka because you want Yokosuka. Everybody wants Yokosuka. So, that's why there's not a lot of houses open in Yokosuka. There are towers. We've got 3-bedroom towers here, if you really want to live on base. If you want to get a house, you're better off looking at a Kago. I mean, that's more often than not, that's what comes up, right? So, there's no process foul. Everything worked fine. The fact that you didn't have anything available to you, you know, I can't help you. I can't help you. So, sorry about that. Okay, this one is for the multiple occasions emails were went out on the website for the movies. This is the MWR movie one. And the show times do not match the actual movies. It happened twice this week. There's actually 2 comments on this one. And I agree, we got to get that aligned. Website, yes, sir. Marquee, movies, and things. There's actually another comment in here later on that says, I'm not so upset, but I went there to see Divergent and Rio 2. Was
Rio 2.
I'd be upset.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty divergent between Divergent and Rio 2. So, yeah, I agree. We got to get our arms around this thing because it's kind of bogus, you know? I mean, you go down there, and I'm not a big fan of 3D, but, you know, 3D's playing, it's not playing. Yeah, we got to do better at this one. I agree. I am upset because the heat has been turned off, and it's rather cold here in Yokosuka. I would say that I personally would rather be cold than hot because when it's really cold, you only have to warm up yourself. When it's hot, you got to cool down the whole building. But, yeah, I got it. It's not dangerously cold. I mean, you know, I camp in 15-degree weather.
Yes, sir.
I know I'm not the norm. In fact, I enjoy cold weather camping, so you know, I can always gear up like every, you know, when it gets really cold. But I understand that you are unsatisfied with the fact that you do not control the heat and the cold, but you also do not pay for electricity. And if I could meter every unit, I would absolutely make a play, say, you do whatever you want, and we will bill you. We already bill contractors who live in our housing.
Yes, we do.
We have some in housing up in Nagishi, and they get a bill, fair market value. We can't bill electricity because we don't have meters everywhere. Maybe we should. I don't know if it's ever going to happen. I would love for that to happen, and I would love you to just do whatever you want. I mean, it's not good for the environment. It's not good for Earth Day, but at least we would have a way of self-policing and rewarding you for not using electricity. Maybe you get some money back. If you do use it, you get billed. But I can't do that because I pay the electric bill, and there are some of you who will not care and will start cranking it all the time, and I just can't have that. So we have to have this cut over time, and we have to control it that way, and this is the way it is. So last one, I think, before we take a break. How are we doing? We got a minute or two? Okay, so we'll do this one more, and that is, since the new beauty salon has opened, I've used it 3 times, and I have to say I'm quite impressed. Not with the appearance of the salon, but also with the entire staff. Yeah, I actually got word of one senior person who went in there and didn't, you know, walked right past the desk. Didn't like that. Something happened with their nails or something like that. And they walked right past the reception desk, went in there, talked right to a person who's having another client already. And then they, you know, say, oh, we'll get you in, we'll get you in. They stormed out. It's just, you know, it's very unprofessional. But the, by and large, the feedback that we get is great things from the salon and their customer service, and they want to do the right thing. I mean, they are, in terms of customer service, a beauty salon is a very personal thing. You are talking, you have a relationship with the person. You don't have a relationship with a person scooping your ice cream at Baskin Robbins. Maybe you do. and maybe it is swimsuit season, so maybe you stop that person's relationship with Baskin Robbins. But you usually do it at the customer service like this, and they do a great job, and everyone knows everyone by name, so I am very impressed as well, and so great job to those folks. And with that, I think we'll take a quick break here, and we'll come back. Hopefully you'll have something, have learned something new with the informational videos that we show with the break. And we'll see when we get back.
When in doubt, log on to the Fleet Activities Yokosuka Facebook page. Staff members at the Public Affairs Office update the page daily, informing service members and their families by providing the latest and the greatest information possible. Information provided also includes off-base activities to keep in touch with our host nation friends. Keep up to date with everything going on in your neighborhood, eliminate the rumor mill, and visit Fleet Activities Yokosuka's Facebook page.
Sexual assault is a problem that affects all of us.
But it's a problem we can step in and prevent.
We can look out for each other.
We can watch how much alcohol we drink.
We can know where our shipmates are going and who they're going with.
We are all in this together.
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 Together. We are U.S. Naval Forces Japan. We value each other's service, and we can all work together to end sexual assault.
Do you know how much water you need every day? Some say 8 to 10 glasses, others say an ounce per pound. But really though, that just depends on you and how hard you go. You should shoot for about a gallon a day. I know it's tough, but you gotta get it in. Back to newer corner. Sometimes I feel like I've been putting on a fake persona. Saturday, Yokosuka. It's a drink up.
If you're a service member or dependent in the Yokosuka area, then you should definitely add Fleet Activities Yokosuka's webpage to your list of favorites. It's a one-stop shop for important numbers, base information, and news. The site is a great place to start to find out anything you need to know about your base. If you're a tenant command or a nonprofit organization, then send all info to yokoskareport@gmail.com.
Welcome back. Welcome back. Okay, let's get to a few more of these good nuggets, pearls. We're dropping pearls over here, pearls of wisdom. So why are there external construction renovation projects in housing while people are living in them? Why do you think, Master Chief?
So we can maintain our housing in an acceptable condition.
That's what I think, too.
I think so.
Okay. Now, can this be scheduled to be done when the houses are vacant?
A lot of times it is. We have several units vacant that are remodeling, but that's internal work. We always work on our external of our buildings.
Yeah, they get kind of beat up. We have to do it. So I came home today. My personal property, bikes, shoes, gardening equipment was moved to the lawn area. In the rain, it says in parentheses here. There's a little story behind this story.
I think so, sir.
Yes, there is. Yeah.
Our public works and housing work together, and when we schedule all the maintenance to our housing areas, it's things as simple as coming into your house to clean your dryers, vent, ducting, painting the exteriors. We're putting in new hot water piping throughout all of housing.
We have outages, and we with those too.
But when we post those flyers on your door, please don't just throw them out. It's not the free stars and stripes. It's actually a notice to you that's telling you, please remove something from a specific location because we're going to do maintenance there, or telling you we're going to paint your building, or we're going to disrupt parking. Housing and Public Works both are very good about publishing these well in advance of the actual event happening. So when you see that notice on your door, take a glance at it, and it's taped there. So if it's like something that's going to affect your house, maybe you could take it inside the door and tape it on the electrical panel so you have it as a reminder.
Yeah, this is part of the additional follow-up. Member stated he did get a flyer with
Throw It Away.
Send him another and tell the contractor's paying the entryway. So the contractor's coming, and you shouldn't have to move your stuff. You know, back in where I grew up, they just paint right over it. If you left your bicycle, they paint parking lot lines over your bicycle.
I mean, here they cover up your car with a...
They are a bit more conscientious than where I grew up, I will say that. So yeah, but we do have a lot of outages, hot water and other. It comes up, and those are actually, they ask my permissions required to do those. It comes a couple weeks in advance. I say always, make sure we get the notification, make sure we put it out there so everybody knows. We try and do water outages, we try and do just in the workday, kind of after you go to work and hopefully before you come home, and those kind of things. So we try and do our part, but no, we cannot defer all maintenance until they're empty, because as you might have noticed, there are only 5% of all units in Yokosuka main base are empty right now. We are very full. We have more flexibility in the Kago, but we still have to do that. So no, we're not going to do that. So pay attention to those flyers. Why do we have to do that? Well, because we're the landlord. You know, you don't own the house, you don't really pay for the house. So you don't have that kind of flexibility to say, I'm willing to take risk with the house. I'm willing to risk deferring maintenance because it's inconvenient this time and I'll wait to change the water here until it really dies. You can't take that risk. And I'm not willing to take that risk on your behalf. So I'm going to have to keep going with the maintenance schedule. So that's that. That's a really more honest answer. I have an issue with the next gas station allowing people to park at the pumps and and in the exit lanes while they are shopping inside the mini mart. Yeah, that bothers me too a bit. I guess I've been fortunate enough that every time that has happened for me, I've been able to get around them, except, you know, when I'm the next in line for gas.
Yes, sir. I mean, the Navy Exchange is looking at it, and they are going to mark the areas by the gas pumps. But there's also another side to this, because when we converted our pumps last year to the credit card, the pumps that accept a card, we no longer have a cashier. So the folks that are paying in cash, they have to park there in front of the pump to go in and pay, because you have to pay before you can pump the gas. So that is a holdup. But primarily, the parking is across the street over by the safety office and VRO.
Please don't park in the rental car spots. Just make a quick left and then a right. There's usually parking there.
And for those of you that just aren't even there to get gas and you pull up and park because you don't want to park across the street, be considerate to our 22,000 neighbors on the installation and park where you're supposed to park.
Yeah, and what I usually do is I try and do my shopping first. So I'll go in to, and pull in by, the, say, the Autoport. Not the Autoport, the actual Autoport where the entrance is for that side. There's a couple spots in there. Park there, go into the mini mart, buy my stuff, and then go on and look at the gas station and go with a credit card or something. I know not everyone has that option, but I mean, just because it would be a long trip around the block.
Yes, sir.
So I make that short turn around the parking lot by the Autoport side. But yeah, don't go in there and just hang out, or there may be another minor.
They also just replaced the car wash in the back very recently.
Oh, yeah,
it does
that's
a great
right.
job, too.
Yeah, so you can take a trip through that. Yay. Kids will love it. Leave the windows down. A lot of fun. So there may be another minor fence report in your future, but yeah, just be considerate and pull forward if you can when you're in there. So it never fails. Every time I enter the bank, this is a community bank, the staff's always friendly and welcoming. Well, that's because they're going to take your money, so of course they're happy to see it. No, they are pretty good over there. They are pretty good over there. What did I say?
I was distracted by our audience.
I'm happy to give me money. Why aren't they me? Okay. So, yes, well, thank you for saying that, because you're actually a community bank. Not everyone has a great banking experience. Not a banking experience. We had one of these comments come up where someone was vilifying some of these things because of the SOFA requirements to use some of these banks. And the person was a retiree. Retirees are actually called out in SOFA, and they have some very specific authorizations that other folks don't have. And by that I mean when the sponsor departs Japan, you can apply for continued logistics support or other things, but you're not allowed, even with continued logistics support. If you don't have SOFA status, you are not authorized to use the commissary, the exchange, the theaters, the clubs, a lot of different things, because it's all about the money. And so if you, SOFA, Status of Forces Agreement with the Government of Japan, allows us to operate here where you will not pay taxes to the government. So very often if someone is here and they're sponsor has transferred back to Konus or something, then if they still live in Japan, they will be shopping in the exchange and not paying taxes to Japan.
Yes.
A lot of the other benefits, which most people don't really care about, are like immigration law and other things too. Well, retirees are actually called out, and they can use the next in the commissary.
Yes.
Very specific line item. In fact, we don't even mention it because it doesn't come up a lot. But the bank, you must be a SOFA member to use the bank, and so they take it very seriously, being about the law and money in particular. So if you don't have your banking card, all you have is your CAC ID card, they turn this person away at some stage. So it's good to hear from a community bank. Yeah, they want your business, and they do a great job, and they are under some very specific constraints. So good on them, and thank you for your comment. I would like the fleet gym to keep the weight room open for 24 hours. Now is that, I assume you mean 24 hours of every day, and you know, all in a row, not just several hours in the week. Because we have more than 24 hours, we actually have
Well, we just got to change.
Just got to change. We were at 90 hours.
Thanks, Captain, for putting in those waiver requests.
I'm just an idea man.
Yes,
that's
sir.
That's pretty much what I do. I'm an idea man. And so we went from 90 hours, and what are we up to?
We just got authorization to go up to 104 hours in our gyms. Our MWR director and sports fitness coordinators are working out the new schedules right now. I believe we also have to hire an extra employee now as well.
Yeah, so in order to make this work, we can do certain things. We've actually kicked around, what's the harm in, some places have like a CAC swipe card, you can get in there. We have to install that thing, but even when we're kicking around, how can we do this? How can we give more access to the fleet gyms? Because that was the building's already open 24 hours, right? You always use the elliptical. They have a stack of towels, and if you're there past noon on Saturday, you're probably not going to get another towel. But at least they try and do their best and assume people be good neighbors. I'm not inclined to leave the free weights open. You know, you're throwing steel around. You generally want to make sure you have a spotter in there. And I know what happens because I used to be this person who'd go there at 2 in the morning or something. Because when I was 20 years old, I never slept. And would do that by myself, because I was bored or I was jet-lagged. Because I usually was jet-lagged is usually why. I would fly back to the States from here when I was on 7th Fleet staff and you hit some gym and, you're trying to whatever. You got nothing to do, so you'd say, hey, maybe I'll tire myself out. And that's really not good with free weights. But anyway, now we have the hours, the authorization. We've got to find the staff.
Yes.
It may require us to move some staff. It may require us to have some interns that are willing to just be safety people and things like that. So we're going to work on that. So this, hopefully by the time this airs, we'll have that worked out. So that'll be, I think our intention right now is to, Purdy Gym will still be 6 days a week because we've got to clean it. It gets a lot of use.
Yes.
It should get a lot of use. It's a beautiful facility, but we do have to deep clean it. Sometimes, especially the weight rooms. But the fleet rec, we're going to open some portion of every day. Saturday and Sunday will be open as well. So there you go. It won't be 24 hours. I apologize. Well, I don't apologize, but
The weight room won't be 24 hours.
But the facility will for the elliptical. But the weight room will be open some portion of every day of the week. Hopefully some portion that is usable by everybody.
Yes.
And that'll help take the load off of, it was only open a little bit on Sunday, and that was it, and Purdy was closed, it became just so jammed there. So hopefully now you can choose to go Saturday or Sunday. Here's a comment about an employee of a food establishment that wears very, very long hair. I'm sure she's probably very proud of it. Probably looks very nice. But it starts to dangle into the plates. That's not good.
I wouldn't eat the food.
Yeah, I wouldn't either. So the general manager has, it says, this is a polite way of saying he's jacked her up. It says, well.
Can you say that on TV, sir?
Sure, I can.
There okay, just
check. Jacked her up. Jacked her up. Jacked her up, stole her tires, and left her on cinder blocks or something.
Yeah.
He basically, got the staff together, reiterated the hygiene requirements and everything else. So, so thanks for pointing that out. So, perhaps it had not been a concern for her. Maybe she's growing her hair out, and now it's been a concern several months later. She hasn't even considered the fact she should wear a hairnet or something. I don't know. Here we go. Home to work bus with a batch of extremely rowdy children.
This is getting to be a monthly one, sir.
Oh, I thought you were going to say phone inside.
Same one. Yeah.
Yes.
I was going to say, but I was keeping myself in check on that one.
Okay. we have a home to work bus. It takes people from Akego to the main base. We have one in Nagishi as well. There's several for Akego. And there's a bunch of extremely rowdy children, the majority of the ride roughhousing, talking loudly. And, but we told you last time, take these kids' names and everything else. But this is getting out of hand. So the person says, fortunately, I would recommend either, recommendations are from the individual, putting a bus attendant on this de facto school bus. Can't do that. I mean, I suppose I could get parental volunteers or something, but, it's not a school bus.
Okay.
And I would not want to imply that it's a school bus. Banning non-commuter ridership. Now you're talking my language.
Yep.
And, or cut the 1600 Akego bus entirely. Now you're talking the money people's language. Since it's low ridership and keeping the place open. So I don't know how I can put this any more clearly. Parents, we got two choices here. Either you get your kids under control, or you're going to drive to Yokosuka to get them. All right? And that's it. Those are your choices. I have no problem shutting this thing down. None. It is not required. It costs me money. You are getting a good deal on me. And there is a requirement to be good citizens of our community. And these kids, maybe they're all getting lathered up on each other's energy at the end of the day. I don't know. But that is not an excuse. They should sit in their seats. They should be respectful. Remember, this is a commuter bus. It is for adults. It is for the sailors who are working on behalf of the nation. And if it keeps up, I will just turf them out and say no more. And when someone comes and says, why this is nonsense, why you're not doing it, I will point right to this ICE comment and say, because you got two shots. Three strikes, you're out. So get your kids under control. I don't think that's unfair.
No, I think it's spot on, Cam. I mean, if the kid wants to, if a child wants to get on the bus, they'll have to have a parent with them.
Yeah, or ride the train.
Yep.
There are, I tell you what, I know a young man who comes down from Tokyo every week. He's 11. Rides the train himself. A lot of people in Japan ride the train himself. You may have your kids ride the train themselves or something. You'd probably say, oh, no, I can't do that. I would not do that. But, you know, be honest with you, I probably wouldn't either. If they weren't, unless they're going with a group. I do. My boy's
right.
A little older. You know, so yeah. They go in a pack and they go off somewhere and they do something. And that's fine. But that may be your option. Maybe your option. So please reiterate to your kids, behave themselves. Flashing speed limit sign. It's related to traffic safety. Several speed warning signs around the base. This is the temporary ones. You know, they have the program for a certain speed,
yep.
And they flash regardless of what speed the car is traveling. This is not good for two reasons. The driver's distracted by the flashing sign, especially by Sullivan's. Well, hopefully not distracted by that. He shouldn't be. There's a lot of distractions in the road. And that shouldn't be the one that gets you. Although I will say, you know, there's a lot of cops get hit on DUI stops because if another drunk driver's coming, they see the light and they kind of get sucked into it. Did you know that?
Didn't know that.
Yeah. Yeah. There are.
But every time it flashes for me, I always check my speed. That's probably good thing, too.
Right. So the sign should only flash if the car is traveling more than speed limit posted. That's one comment that they're distracting. I'm not so sure I'm sold on that one. But because the signs always flash, over time drivers begin to ignore the signs. Now that one I am willing to go with. And so I'm not sure if perhaps they just set them really high or set them really low, so they always flash or don't, and which might be somewhat intellectually lazy or perhaps we don't know how to set them. But yes, they should be set for the right speed so that they flash when you are over. I know exactly what you're talking about, and you do. You say, oh, I want to stop flashing. So we should do that. We'll look into that. AmeriCable, treat your customers in a more professional manner. There's not a lot of feedback. There's no contact information. So AmeriCable answers this thing. But I'll just take the opportunity to put AmeriCable on notice. Put it on notice. The internet speeds have caught the watchful eye of everybody. So we're trying to look for some solutions here that might give you a better speed option in the future. I just hope it happens sometime before my POD. But yeah, we're gonna, because there should be more options than, you know, their contract was signed. It's a 20-year contract for AmeriCable. And that's not uncommon. Sometimes things like Chili's, you know, they had a long-term contract and a no competition because they also put money into the infrastructure.
Yes.
They repair the building. So they get a certain number of years. You're guaranteed we won't throw you out because that's how long it's going to take to make up the difference of the money you put into this building that you're only borrowing. And the same is true of sometimes the fiber optic lines, the cable lines. You say, hey, we want a long contract. We're going to dig all these trenches and put these lines in, and it's going to take us years to make it up. So I don't know how they, but of course, 20 years. 10 years ago, no one envisioned a Netflix, a Hulu, a streaming whatever, and that's where we find ourselves. The world has changed so much from when this contract was laid out there. So even if we can't, say, renegotiate this contract, provided that the lawyers are looking at this thing, if there's nothing in it that says you can't have competition, then I am all for competition. Never be afraid of it. Let some of those folks who are out in town come on in here and start providing us 40 megabits a second. There's other stuff. So, but obviously, there's a lot. There's some issues.
I've seen a lot of sailors get those little Miffies, the little box. You can just carry it in your pocket, and they actually have some pretty high speeds.
They do. I've heard of 40, 50,
yes.
And they work anywhere in Japan.
Yes.
So you're out at your cafe somewhere else. You've got your own hotspot. You're not sharing with everybody. And that's what? Anywhere between 50 and 80 bucks a month,
yes, sir.
I think, is where they come
Depends
in.
Depends on the speed that you purchase.
Yeah. Yeah. So I would talk to somebody, though. Just like the cell phone, sometimes it's different coverage. Sometimes those have different coverage on base. And if you were kind of a homebody, you're going to hang out at the Starbucks and don't want to share the internet connection there or something. If you want to go somewhere else, you know, I would research with some of your friends. But yeah, the Miffies, those are a good deal, too. But we are going to look at this. We've already looked at it. We are in earnest putting it through a JAG review to see what can be done, what we are allowed to do to get some competition in here, and it'll only make us all better, right? Never be afraid of competition in business. If someone else is better, then they should put you out of business, right? Okay, here's that another same person applied for this four-bedroom townhouse.
That's a repeat.
Okay, that's a repeat.
Yep.
Yeah. Still not getting
He's out. Got like four comments in there.
Yeah. Well, I see these. And sometimes people may have been a long time if people think I didn't see it there. So, nope, no harm in that. Okay. I'd like to thank security for being so devoted to the enforcement of parking regulations in the DC housing area. Despite the fact that I park a few inches over the line to help my handicapped neighbor have room to exit her vehicle, I was undeniably over the line. And the space wasn't used to me, but I suppose it needs to be fully available in the event of a lack of parking in the Gishi. So the MA has shown me the error of my ways, and that indeed no good deed goes unpunished. Well, your sarcasm is greatly appreciated. So, And hopefully you see, not only is there sarcasm in this response, but irony. Yeah. Because I had sarcasm on your sarcasm. You see what I did there? Yeah, that was good. Okay, here's the deal. Here's a standard. Here's you. Here's your ticket. It's that simple. The fact that you're parking to give your neighbor more room, they should park in a handicapped spot or something. No, you don't just break the rules because it seems to make good sense to you at the time or you have some mitigating factor. That's nonsense. Rules, you, tickets.
Yes, sir.
I can remember next one.
I think we're going to be issuing a lot of tickets up out
we
there
are, yeah.
pretty soon. Did you, I say that out loud,
you
Kevin?
You will never see me coming. That's my imitation of the Mandarin.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're never going to see us coming.
Yep.
Which reminds me, safety fair on the 21st.
Absolutely.
I forgot to mention that earlier. Safety fair on the 21st of May. It's going to be in the Red Brick area.
Yes, sir.
Coincident with our safety stand down right before Memorial Holiday. Always good to have a stand down when you start to change to sports and stuff like that. But also a good opportunity to swing by there. They'll have some traffic safety stuff.
Yep.
Maybe you're out on your bicycle. Maybe it's been a while since it was registered. You forgot all the different things you're supposed to have on it, like lights and bells and whistles, because you don't drive it at night or something. But swing by the fair.
Yeah.
And so some of these other minor offenses we're talking about, you...
Not just for adults either, Captain. They usually do some cool stuff for the kids out there, too. So
they do. Yeah, and so it should be fun. I think it's 10 to 1,400 or something.
Yes, sir.
Brick. I think the safety standard is longer than that. Okay, here's one. I'm grateful for the Child Watch program Prairie Gym has brought back to parents. Thank you. It's it. I would love to do more of that. But here's the kind of comment. My daughter woke up this morning at 8:15. She's getting ready to go to a 9 o'clock spot at the Child Watch. And she began to throw up. So I apologize, or not apologize. I'm sorry that your child was having a tough time with it. Hopefully she feels better. Hopefully by now she feels better. So they called the gym, it was around 8:25, to say I'm not coming, required about cancellation, and maybe use the payment towards another day, and was informed that because I hadn't called before 7, my payment could not be used for another day, and I was out of luck. And then I asked the employee on the phone if I should bring in my sick kid and getting around other kids sick. Okay, here's the deal. We are not going to eat it. We're not. I mean, sometimes, I would say act of God, bad weather, stuff like that. Why should MWR take a loss because of an unfortunate circumstance?
Yeah.
So we're not going to. So the reason we have to call by 7 is that someone else who's dropping off their kids can say, hey, is there now an opening? You can't just cancel at the last minute and expect there to be no ramifications. You think about dental, hospital, medical, they've got hundreds of cancellations.
Yes.
And I would say, my advice to the XO of the hospital, who's a friend of mine, I said, it should be a policy where, hey, you miss your first appointment, your next appointment you're paying for it, out in town. You had your shot, you didn't cancel, and so there's someone else who's now got to wait 3 weeks for dental because you didn't show up. So that is obviously not the case here. I know it's unfortunate your child was sick, but you know, you're asking me to pick up your tab, right? And so there's some service we can't do because we can't fill that hole. I feel bad about a lot of these things. Even the Spring Festival, we had a lot of organizations who got there. I mean, terrible weather, couldn't see that coming. We couldn't refund the fact that you had a table. But even the organizations that I am near and dear to my heart, they lost hundreds of dollars. Where they normally make thousands, they lost hundreds of dollars. And there's nothing you can do because if... I'm sorry, it's kind of like spreading the pain out among the community, but you know, I can't take a loss of tens of thousands either by doing that.
And it does add up.
There is a reason why you have to cancel by a certain time. And even if the reason is good, or the car broke down, or a child is sick, you can't use it, that does not change the fact that we can't use that time. You have booked it, and we can't re-flag it for somebody. So you just have to eat it instead of us eating it. So I regret that that's the case, but I think you hopefully understand my point. Hopefully you understand this. There's no standing. We don't have like a walk-in. Well, we have a walk-in, I guess. People can come by, but we generally don't have like medical appointments or standing class. We don't do that. Let's see here. I have to blow that one off. Oh, this one's a dumpster one. Actually, it's one of our guys.
Yeah.
Catch that action? Yeah, you can't bring your trash from off-base on base. There's a dumpster over by self-help, and the comment was basically, person lives off base in Yokohama, PCSing of all this trash, and they went to self-help to drop it off, and were told it's only for like refrigerators and large furniture, and things like that, which kind of makes sense, they want to get rid of it, but not all your trash. So you have to sort it and get rid of it via the city. You live in the city, And there's certain rules. You can't just bring your trash on base. We talked about that
one. Yes, we did. And folks are still doing it, too. You have to use the trash for the area, the local trash disposal at the area you live off base.
Yeah.
You know, hey, it's great. You don't want to sort your trash, and you just want to fill up the dumpsters on the base. But really, you need to get with the program and sort the trash and put it out into the street the right way.
You have to.
Sir?
You have to. There was a suggestion last month about, hey, we should have our MAs look in the back of cars for trash because we think people are coming out. I'm not going to do that, but that's unfortunate. So here's one for DC2 eBay. I-B-A-Y. eBay is how it's pronounced. I-B-A-Y is how it is spelled. And I say that because a lot of you folks know them. Okay? But DC2 was one of the most helpful personnel I've experienced in the Navy in the whole last 3 years. In the Navy as a whole, in the last 3 years. Assisted at the end of the day, worked day on a Friday, coordinating transportation, everything else. Yeah, he's a great guy. So
yes,
we just basically re-enlisted him.
Yes.
And that's great. And he's moving on, I'm forced to say. But I want to spell that out because a lot of you folks know him. He also helps manage AOBICR. And so a lot of you, he deals with a lot of you people, and hopefully you agree. So I did want to say congratulations on your re-enlistment, and good job there, DC2.
Yep.
And hopefully everyone in the community does a great job. Yeah. So here's one real quick, the Navy Lodge. This person, they requested a room change, and they were told no. And they asked for a free computer, and the customer also said no, and said something like, I visited the BOQ and made the ice comment. It's worse than the BOQ in Hawaii. Well, there's no reason to get nasty on this one. No, I'm just kidding. Nothing against the BOQ in Hawaii. I actually stayed at Makalapa. I've stayed at Lockwood Hall, I'm not so thrilled with, but I've stayed at Makalapa, and they're fine. So the person here, here's the story. They're not on orders. It's a guest legal, a guest leisure traveler. And you're not on orders. So we're not going to turf out a family for your personal preference here. You have a room. You should be thankful you have a room. It is a business thing, and you can't always get what you want, but you know there is a prioritization scheme. Yes, it's a business, but we do prioritize based on need, and you just don't have the need or the justification to move that up. And just to make sure I got it right, she went right in and put another ice comment. I made the ice comment last night. I was told the front desk to try and find a room with a bathtub. Okay. I think I've covered that.
Yes.
You are not on official orders. So even if you were, there's no guarantee that that's going to happen. So, yes. I think I've had enough of that.
Yes, sir.
I've made that point.
Yes, sir.
So they try and be accommodating, but they're here for the families. They're here for transitioning families. It's really important. And here's one here. My family and I are extremely pleased with Wednesday sports days at Nagishi. They attended every one of them each week, and more kids come out to participate. Now, as you know, Nagishi's shutting down. Eventually, it's going to be transitioned back to the government of Japan. So we've had a town hall out there. We've described some things. I've signed out a bunch of letters authorizing folks to move. You should be getting those. Hopefully, by the time you're seeing this, you are one of those people. That's based on a survey we sent out.
Yes, sir.
And if you respond in the survey that you'd like to move right away, then we're giving you a letter right away. If you blew off the survey, then you got nothing. So we'll eventually get you one if you want one. But I didn't want to put out a blanket to all these people, then I have all these hanging out there. I just want to know who's going to move and who's not going to move.
Yep.
That's the base of the survey. Who wants to move, who's not going to move? Because I only have authorized so many intrastation moves per year. And that's what this is. So you have a house on base, and I'm moving you to a house on base. So intrastation, interstation move. Only have so many. So obviously I'm going to give them to those folks that want them, and otherwise I have to kind of allocate for those. And I know I got some moves coming next year with the whole swap of the George Washington.
Yes.
For the Ronald Reagan. And not a lot of families, because most of those folks will stay with their respective carrier. But there's going to be a surge of, just kind of a peak time. So I'm trying to make sure I plan that accordingly. And so this is based on your survey. But yes, we haven't forgotten about Nagishi. Things are going to be closing down. The school-age care, I think we have one registered person in school-age care. And when that person leaves, then we're going to close school-age care. And that'll have other impacts because that also is tied to the teen center and other things. But you know, we cannot justify a whole lot of usership. So we are we're committed to giving as much as we can now. And that's why there's a Wednesday sports day. And people enjoy that a lot. We're going to try and keep doing that. So for those folks out in Nagishi, you hopefully have your move letters.
Yeah.
They describe everything. Basically, you take that anytime, as long as you have more than 6 months left before your PRD, you can take that to housing, and that day you fill out your assignment. We'll give you the list of everything available that day. Yeah. You got your 48 hours, as if you just got here, and you pick your place and go. So if this is news to you and you live in Nagishi, then by all means, go down to housing and inquire, where do I get this magical letter from the CEO that lets me do that? And we'll make that happen. Actually, go to your housing office at Nagishi, because they're the ones who can work that. They're the ones who have the housing surveys. So I think with that, we've covered all the good news. We've got three pools open. We got more gym hours coming. We're authorizing the moves from Nagishi. And that's all pretty good stuff coming
yes, sir.
Here into summertime. We got a safety fair on the 21st of May. Hopefully, we'll see you out there.
And unfortunately, you're not going to make this one, but the Curry Fest is this weekend, so.
Yes, I hope you had an enjoyable time
yes.
at the Curry Festival in Mikasa Park.
It's
a great
time.
But what we'll be out there for is Keigo Friendship Day.
Yes, sir.
On the 24th, I believe it's a Saturday.
Saturday the 24th, sir.
And out of the Keigo, and that's going to be awesome. So you folks on main base who've never been to a Keigo and keep telling people how you couldn't possibly have lived there because a whole 10 kilometers away, which is 6.2 miles, there's that sarcasm, free of charge. Yeah,
with the free bus, too.
Go out there and enjoy that, too.
Free bus.
Yeah, go out there and enjoy that as well. And unfortunately, I will not be there myself. I'm taking a bunch of Cub Scouts to a campground where I'll come back frazzled.
I'll be in up in Tokyo with our CSAD receiving their good conduct award.
Good
on you guys,
Tokyo.
CSAD.
Yeah.
All of the CSAD chapters for every command.
Yeah.
Great week, good month. Summer's almost here. It's nice and warm out.
A lot of sunlight in the morning. A lot of sunlight at night. You got a lot of long days. A lot to do. So make the most of it. Enjoy it, and we'll see you next time.